Once a thriving woodland, it became a symbol of the environmental devastation wrought by the disaster. This transformation is the origin of its name, a haunting reminder of the catastrophic event that occurred nearby. However, over the years, it has become a unique ecological niche, turning into an unintended wildlife sanctuary. Hello guys, today we continue the series which you all said is a great idea. So again, we move into the comparison between the real-life Chernobyl Exclusion Zone and its depiction in our game, Chernobylite. Same as previously, we will give you context information about the real place inside the zone, but also a bit about its importance to Chernobylite's narrative and atmosphere. If you haven't heard it yet, we have just announced the sequel, Chernobylite 2 Exclusion Zone. Check out the announcement trailer later. You can find it on the channel's main page and also linked in this video description. I also encourage you to wishlist it on Steam. You will find the link in the first pinned comment, as YouTube doesn't like linking to other sites. But for now, let's start. Chernobyl Exclusion Zone. The fusion of fact and fiction. Part 9. The Red Forest. The Red Forest, located within the Chernobyl Exclusion Zone, is one of the most infamous areas affected by the 1986 Chernobyl disaster. Spanning approximately 10 square kilometers around the Chernobyl nuclear power plant, the Red Forest got its name from the reddish-brown color of the pine trees that absorbed lethal doses of radiation following the reactor explosion. The forest, once a thriving woodland, became a symbol of the environmental devastation wrought by the disaster. However, despite the high levels of radiation that persist to this day, the Red Forest has also become an accidental wildlife sanctuary, where nature has found a way to adapt and even thrive in the absence of human activity. In real life, the Red Forest was one of the most severely contaminated areas following the Chernobyl disaster. The explosion released radioactive isotopes such as iodine-131, cesium-137, and strontium-90, which heavily contaminated the surrounding area, including the forest. The pine trees in the forest absorbed a significant amount of radiation, causing them to turn a ginger-brown color and eventually die. This transformation gave the Red Forest its name, a haunting reminder of the catastrophic event that occurred nearby. In the immediate aftermath of the disaster, the Soviet government took measures to manage the contamination in the Red Forest. The top layer of soil, along with the dead trees, was removed and buried in trenches, covered with a thick layer of clean soil to contain the radioactive materials. Despite these efforts, the area remains one of the most contaminated on Earth, with radiation levels, in some spots, still high enough to pose serious health risks to anyone who lingers too long. Over the years, however, the Red Forest has become a unique ecological niche. Despite the radiation, the forest has not only regrown but has also become home to a variety of wildlife, including species not typically observed in the region before the disaster. The absence of human activity has allowed nature to reclaim the area, turning the Red Forest into an unintended wildlife sanctuary. Researchers continue to study the Red Forest to understand how ecosystems recover from such catastrophic events and how radiation affects flora and fauna over the long term. In recent years, the Red Forest has also been in the news for other reasons. During the 2022 Russian invasion of Ukraine, Russian forces moved through the Chernobyl Exclusion Zone, stirring up radioactive dust as they passed through the forest. Reports suggest that the soldiers suffered from radiation sickness after digging trenches in the highly contaminated soil, though these claims remain unconfirmed. This incident highlighted the ongoing dangers associated with the Red Forest and the broader Chernobyl Exclusion Zone. In Chernobylite, the Red Forest is recreated with outstanding attention to detail, capturing both the eerie beauty and the underlying dangers of the real-life location. We have crafted an environment that reflects the Red Forest's complex history, its transformation from a vibrant woodland to a radiation-stricken wasteland, and eventually to a strangely thriving ecosystem. The in-game version of the Red Forest serves as a key location in Chernobylite where you must wander through the hazards of radiation while exploring the mysteries that the forest holds. You don't know who will you meet, what will you see, and what dangers will be lurking in the dark. But if you succeed, you will discover a lot of important information that maybe will allow you to better understand what happened to Igor's beloved Tatiana, his purpose in this haunting world of Chernobylite. In our game, the Red Forest is not just a setting asset. We created it to be an integral part of the atmosphere as well as the narrative. Yes, we prepared exact 3D models, changeable weather conditions, some fighting and an eerie atmosphere. But the story is the most important, and it's the key factor that will lead you to explore this place yourselves, either inside the basic mode, in the free play mode, or during the peaceful tour around the zone mode. The forest is depicted as a place where the natural and the supernatural intertwine, with the lingering effects of the Chernobyl disaster creating an environment that is both haunting and captivating. The trees, still bearing the ginger-brown hue that gave the forest its name, stand as silent witnesses to the past, while the undergrowth and wildlife reflect the resilience of nature in the face of human-induced catastrophe. We use the Red Forest in Chernobylite to explore themes of survival, adaptation, and the long-term impact of environmental disasters. You must contend with the persistent threat of radiation, which adds a layer of tension to your exploration of the forest. The radiation in Chernobylite is not just a background detail, but a dynamic element that affects gameplay, requiring you to carefully manage your exposure, plan your next steps, and manage both your own gameplay and your allies' missions, if you send them to this hazardous territory. The in-game Red Forest also serves as a reminder of the real-world consequences of the Chernobyl disaster. We infused the environment with a sense of history, making it clear that this is a place where past and present collide. By exploring the Red Forest in Chernobylite, you will gain a deeper understanding of the environmental and human cost of the disaster, as well as the resilience of nature in the face of overwhelming adversity. In both the real world and in Chernobylite, the Red Forest stands as a powerful symbol of the Chernobyl disaster, a place where the scars of the past are still visible, yet where life continues to find a way to endure. Our depiction of this iconic place is a testament to our commitment to capturing the complex reality of this unique and tragic location, making it an essential part of your journey through the Chernobyl Exclusion Zone. As always, I hope you have enjoyed this video and maybe even learned something new or interesting. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe, as there is going to be much more info, for example on our Chernobylite 2 Exclusion Zone, in the following weeks and months. If you have any questions, including the game's sequel, feel free to write in the comments section. That's it for today, guys. Take care, stay safe, and see you on Sunday.